the income here, or the gross rental income, is going to be similar to the Ritz-Carlton today. So we have the one bedrooms at about 5,500, 5,300 or so for the larger ones. And then the smaller ones would step down maybe to, you know, 4,500, you know, to maybe 30, let's say, what's it? Let's say 50, let's say 5,300, like 4,500, and maybe like 3,700 or so. You know, and then for the studios, you could probably get like 2,800. Two bedroom units, you could probably get like 7,400.
How big's the, how many square feet?
And it really depends on the floor and the view as well. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Each floor, the two bedroom is different?
Oh no, sorry, in terms of the rental rate.
Oh, I'm sorry.
Yeah, so.
Higher than more expensive?
Yeah. So I think that the floor plans, like on the 23rd floor, this unit here, the larger two bedroom, sticks out with a pop out. And then that becomes 1,710 square feet, and that's the largest unit that we have in Tower 1, except for the penthouses. And then penthouses, we have 8 penthouses, 4 2-bedroom penthouses around 1,800 square feet, and then 4 3-bedroom penthouses are about 3,100 square feet.
Cool. Mm-hmm. May I know how many elevators do you have?
Four. Yeah.
So how many total sharing?
There's 10 units per floor.
Okay.
Yeah.
Sharing floor.
Yeah, so 300 units, 308 units total.
Okay.
From 8th floor and up.
From 7th floor and up.
Seven.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Right. And so in terms of starting prices for this, we have studios starting at 510,000. Okay. The smallest one bedroom is starting at about 630,000. As you get bigger, the one bedrooms, the middle one is about 730,000. The corner one starts at about 830,000. For the north corner, the south corner starts at 880,000. The two bedrooms, the smaller one starts at 1.1 million. And then the large one starts at 1.2 million. And then once you hit the 23rd floor, when it becomes a 1,700 square feet, starts at 1.6 million. And then penthouses are not priced yet. Yeah. But
so far, do you have a list of those already priced?
Yeah.
Yes. So, you know, so where we are right now with the sales process is that in the early days, once we started, like reaching out to downtown residents and to the brokers who sold a lot downtown and with their clients, we built up an interest list. And a reservation list for about, we had about 450 people on that list since the summer when we started reaching out. So of these people, you know, we went to just 10 days ago after we finalized all the floor plans and have everything printed out. We said, okay, when, you know, developers offering an incentive, you can now come in and hold a unit. You can pick a unit, and you know that is your unit for purchase. We are going to let two buyers pick one unit. Every unit is going to have two buyers.
Wow.
Okay. So one is in first position, one is in backup position.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. And so the developers are offering an incentive where for $10,000 to hold a one bedroom.
Mm-hmm.
The developer will give you $10,000 at closing for closing costs, for loan fees, HOA fees, transfer taxes, things like that, right? Okay, so that's the incentive for a one-bedroom or studio. For a two-bedroom or penthouse, you can put a $20,000 deposit, and then the developer will give you $15,000 credit, okay? For the two bedrooms, you can hold one, just like the one bedrooms. For the penthouse, they don't let you hold it. They just put you on the list. Yeah. Now, we did this about 10 days ago, to the people on our 400 person list. Right now we have 100, we were given 100 units from the developer to start allowing the buyers to hold. So out of the 100 units, within a week we locked up 80 of them. We went back to the developer to get additional inventory. They gave us 50 more units, so now we had 70. As of today, we only have 32 left in first position. So some buyers are now in backup position. So they are coming in to be backup position for these units. Once we fill up the backup position, we're going to start taking reservations for Tower 2. But we don't have as much information yet on Tower 2, and we probably don't have floor plans and everything for people to lock in yet.
Mm-hmm.
But we are basically, you know, using this process to really engage the broker as well as the buyer to come in early, pick the unit, you know, secure your spot so that you have the unit of your choice when we're ready to launch. So when we do launch, you know, basically we're still working on that final timing. It could be as soon as January, or it could be after we have a full model unit built out. Because right now we're working on getting a new sales center, building out the full model units and everything else. We may not go to contract until we have that, or maybe the developer will push for us to do it earlier. But what we're planning is sometime before Chinese New Year or around Chinese New Year. Yeah.
I have a question. Say, if I reserve one, I have a cousin who wishes to buy something like this in downtown LA.
Yeah.
May I later on assign that to the true buyer and still enjoy the incentive?
Yes. So in this period now, yes.
Yes.
If you identify or if you sign one of these reservations yourselves,
mm-hmm.
then,
yeah,
and put the deposit down,
yeah,
we will let you assign that reservation to your client.
I see. Oh, okay.
We don't tell that to everyone, but you know, basically, we are allowing the signing up to the point of contract.
It's good to know.
Okay. So at the time of contract, we have to identify who the true buyer is.
Yes.
Is that what you mean?
Yes, but we much rather work directly with you to identify that buyer today.
Okay.
Okay.
I understand.
So, but we do allow the assignment. Up to the point
the
end
contract.
Of the contract. But we do require that, you know, that deposit to be deposited to Chicago Title. So that money will be cashed into escrow.
But one thing is, so everyone, once the contract is signed, there's no return, okay?
Mm-hmm.
You have to close that. Am I correct?
Correct.
Okay, say a little more about that.
Yeah, so once we have, basically right now it's a refundable deposit.
Yeah.
If you deposit the $10,000, it's your option to purchase.
Mm-hmm.
And you have locked in the unit of your choice or in backup position,
mm-hmm.
right? But you do not know exact price yet. And we don't have the exact HOA fees to give you yet. So we give you guidance on the price. You know, we tell you high floor B unit is going to be between, you know, well, the B unit is the largest one, right? The high floor B unit will be between 1.8 and 2 million, let's say, for example. So we want to make sure that your buyer or whoever you are representing is comfortable with that, because we want to have a very high conversion rate, obviously, of our deposits. So, you know, we give you the guidance, but ultimately the developer sets the price at the launch. So ultimately they're not going to deviate too far from our range. But you know, that's not going to be set till later. Once you sign the contract, it will be a 10% non-refundable down payment. Okay. Prior to that, we have HSBC, we have Wells Fargo, we have New American Funding, and maybe East West Bank as our partners to work with your buyers to get pre-approval. Okay. So because we will require the pre-approval unless they are all cash, and then they have to show proof of funds. Okay, so otherwise, if they have the pre-approval, then some banks like Wells Fargo offers a 2-year interest rate lock. So that's a good selling point too, you know, in terms of downside, locking in your interest rate. And then when you sign a contract, you have to, buyer has to be comfortable that they are ready, they can get the loan or has the cash to purchase, because it's a no contingency contract. And then once you are in escrow, you basically, it's a 10% down. You do nothing until you close escrow when we deliver the building.
Mm-hmm.
And then you close escrow. Obviously, there's in the contract, there's going to be buyer default and seller default provisions. Seller default, if seller can't deliver the project in time or up to a certain outside date, or there's material changes between what's been promised, and you know, there's the buyer can walk away. But typically, you know, it's going to be a very, you know, non-contingent contract, so that if you make the decision to purchase, you have to be comfortable with your financing and close escrow. But the great thing is, on the upside, is that you, with 10% down, you've locked in your price, your unit for 2 years with a lot of upside in downtown Los Angeles. You know that Greenland is selling Tower 2 and Tower 3, and we are starting prices of Tower 2 and 3 is higher. And you have instant equity when you close escrow, right? The developer is requiring a one-year lockout on resale. So after you close escrow in end of 2016, you cannot resell your unit for 1 year. So you cannot compete with us on the resale. And during the contract period, you cannot assign the contract. So you cannot go and basically try to flip the contract. Yeah.
So just 10% down before escrow, right?
10% down when you sign the contract, and then right now that's the provision, no additional payment until closing. Yeah. But all of that will be, you know, finalized, but that's the understanding right now.
Could you say it again about the Tower 1, when you're gonna deliver the, 2016, the end of 2016?
End of 2016 is when we are scheduled for completion.
Okay, that's Tower 1.
Tower 1.
Okay.
Can I ask, do you just sell this building in the state? Do you have sales office in China?
Yeah, so we have, well, Douglas Elliman, we just filed our offering plan in New York. And then I'm going to Art Basel in Miami, where we have our offices there. You know, developer is going to be giving us inventory outside of this 150 units to sell in different markets. So in the States as well as in Asia. So in terms of, you know, in Shanghai, Greenland has their overseas sales center. So there will be some units that will be released to them there.
Same price.
Yeah, same price sheet. Yeah.
By the way, do you have the website for this project for more detailed information?
Uh-huh. Yes, it's metropolislosangeles.com.
Mm-hmm. Metropolis Los Angeles.
Yeah.
Okay.
What I can also do is, Kelvin, I'll send you a link to a Dropbox.
Yeah.
Okay.
It has all the floor plans,
some
of the renderings.
That's great.
And then also our registration.
The price range?
We don't have the price range there, but I can give it to you in an email.
Yes, please.
Okay.
Yeah. Please send it to me. I'll send it to all my agents,
right.
So
oh,
that
right.
They can go out and
website.
Talk to their client.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
Let
me
repeat what you said. I have to reserve the spot. That's a $10,000 fee. Is that refundable?
Okay, the $10,000 is a fully refundable deposit to hold your space for one unit. And the developer, in return for identifying that buyer early, is offering them to lock in that unit so that you have either the first option to buy or the second option to buy, and the $10,000 incentive at closing.
That's for one bedroom, about two bedrooms.
For two bedroom, it's a $20,000
deposit.
Okay. And then they give you 15 in incentive.
Incentive is 15,000. But once the contract is signed, there's no
it's not refundable anymore.
Okay. Yeah. And then your deposit rolls into your down payment. Yeah.
So Kelvin, why don't you pay all the you can pay the deposit to book all the, then we can resell that. That's refundable. Just kidding.
I'll pay you back.